Welcome to this presentation from the Urban Penguin. My name is Andrew Mallett and we're going to look at the very basic configuration needed for an Apache HTTP server. You can catch up with these videos on my YouTube channel or at theurbanpenguin.com, and you can follow me on Twitter or Facebook. So welcome to this, a new series of videos we're going to have on configuring and using the Apache web server. Rather than just install the Apache web server, we're going to look at creating in this video a minimal configuration for your HTTP server. This way we can understand what each directive does in the file and how we can load the modules that are required rather than have 30 or 40 modules. We'll find in this video that we can have a 14 line configuration file for our httpd.conf. That's just 14 lines, and of course we're going to understand what each one of those lines does. So the nice thing about Apache is the configuration doesn't really change whether we're looking it on Linux, Solaris, or Windows 32. So here we're working on a CentOS machine, but it shouldn't really matter. Obviously the ways you install the application is going to be different. So we're going to start off installing the HTTP daemon, and we'll also put in the command line browser W3M just to simplify the process in looking at the web pages that we create. So it's going to be yum-y to accept any prompt, and then we're going to be installing the httpd and W3M. So the installation will then go ahead, and once it has installed we can go through and take a look at the configuration. So the configuration by default will be in etc httpd and in the conf directory, and there's our httpd.conf. So this is the glue that holds everything together. If we want to simplify it, we can make our own configuration file, but before we do that, let's just have a look at the web server. So if we start the service, so service httpd start, don't worry about the error there, it's just that it can't resolve the host name. So that doesn't really matter. So that's an error that we can accept. But if we go through and have a look at the loaded module, so Apache CTL minus capital M, and this loads all of the currently loaded modules. And there are many modules here that you're never going to use. Yeah, okay, the proxy module, sure, I can understand that that might be loaded, but probably not when we're using it as a web server as well. So we have more modules loaded than we need, and even though that's okay, we can say, well, the system does work. We're going to look at configuring the server so that we know everything that's gone into the configuration file. So if we stop our web server and then we'll create our httpd.conf from scratch. So we'll make a copy of it, so move, or we'll rename it. So this is going to be the original one with the .old extension, and if we go straight in then and then edit the http.conf, and of course we have an empty file. And the first thing that we're going to need is a line that says listen, and this is going to specify the IP address and the port that we want the Apache web server to listen on. So we're going to configure it to listen only on IP version 4, but any interface, and on port 80. So 0.0.0:80. The next parameters or directive that we'll put in is for the user and group account to use. So these are both going to be Apache on CentOS, but you might have to check what accounts you want them to use on your system. They can use any account, but of course they need the appropriate permissions and the accounts must exist. Now we're going to set up that server name parameter so it won't whinge about trying to resolve the server name from the IP address. and then we'll put where we want to send our error logs through, and we'll send them through to the var log error.log file. We're now going to load a couple of Apache modules. We saw before from the minus M option that we had many modules loaded. We're going to load just the modules that we need to use. So if we want to control access by IP address, then we're going to need the auth host module. And that will be normal, especially if we've got an intranet server that we don't want accessible from the outside world. So we can put then an entry like this. Well, we're going to look in the modules directory for mod underscore auth z underscore host.so. And then we'll add in another module that will allow us to set the default web page. Normally it's going to be the indexed HTML. And that's mod underscore dir. To be able to use the mod underscore dir, we're going to look at that straight away by putting in the directive directory index. And we'll set this to index.html. So if we specify just the server name, like www.example.com, then we'll look for a page in the document root called index.html. So we'll define the document root where our web pages are located, and we'll define that on this machine as var www and then html. So we're going to have to set up then some permissions and options for that directory. So we open up a directory block, and that block is going to be for the said directory, so var www html. The directory can be anywhere, it doesn't really matter. You choose where you want the document root of your web server to be. And we'll close off the block with the /// directory. And we'll put in an option here, override with two R's in the middle, none. So this is just making sure that if anybody puts in like an HT access file, they can't overwrite any of the options that we specify for this directory. And then we'll control access by IP address. So we want to be able to say that the local machines can have access. So we can then go through and specify. And we'll say order allow and deny. So everybody is denied except those in the allow list. And we'll create an allow list, allow from, and then our local network 192.168.0.0/24, so our 24-bit subnet mask. So with that in place, we have a minimal configuration now for our Apache web server. I'm not saying we won't need to set anything more, but this will set up a very minimal web server. We'll just double check that the web page, the index.html, is in place. So if I go through to var www.html and index.html, I've created a page earlier just with the word hello in it, but it will work for us. So if we now check the configuration, so Apache CTL config test, so we've got the syntax correct. And if we then go through and start our service, so service httpd and start, and we'll double check we can access our website, so 192.168.0.85, and there's our welcome page. So we didn't have to specify index.html, the directory index did that for us. And we can go back and just take a quick look at the configuration file. So this has shown you how to make a minimal configuration. But we'll just take a moment to look at where the module file. We can see that we're loading them, but if we want to know where they are, if we move back to the server root, so that's going to be in the HTTP directory. If we do an ls here, we can see we've got a symbolic link to modules, so cd into modules, and then ls. These are all of the modules that we have loaded on this system. but rather than they all load when the Apache server starts, we're only loading the modules that we require. So we've put in the mod dir and the auth host. If we want to check where this actually is, because obviously this was a symbolic link, if I go pwd minus capital P, it will then show me that these modules are in Unix system resources, lib64, httpd, and then modules. But thank you, and I really hope you found this lesson useful.